that we have the Raytech MI3 sensing head installed, we are going to go over how to set up the RAY MI3 comm box. But before we do that, we'll go over some of the buttons. Right here you have the alarm indicator. Down here is the page button. Then we have the up and down buttons. And finally, the enter button. We are going to have an outline of the head setup menu pop up on the left side of your screen for reference. On the screen, you have the object temperature that the sensing head is reading right now. Next, we have T ambient, which is the ambient temperature of the sensing head. First thing we're going to do is press the down button, which will take us to emissivity. We can change the emissivity value for the selected head. Press enter and choose the appropriate emissivity level based on the material we are looking at by using the up and down arrows. Once you have selected that, press enter and then the down button, which will bring us to transmissivity. You can adjust the value in a similar fashion. Just press enter and use the arrows to select the appropriate value when using protective windows. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that if you don't make a selection within 10 seconds, the value will go back to default as we just saw. The next setting is averaging. This will smooth out the signal, and you can choose from 0 to 998.9 seconds. Once average is set above 0 seconds, it automatically activates. On the display, you will see any signal processing functions you have selected. Next is peak hold, which will hold a maximum temperature for a selected period of time. The range is from 0 seconds to 998.9 seconds. Press enter and then select the hold time using the up or down arrows. Press enter to select and note that this will actually remove the averaging that we had previously set up. Next is valley hold, which will hold the minimum temperature for a selected period of time. The range is from 0 seconds to 998.9 seconds. Next is trigger. We can define the trigger mode for the selected head. If you select trigger, a logical low signal at input FTC3 will reset the peak or valley hold function. If you set to hold, this mode acts as an externally generated hold function. The temperature will be written to the output until a new transition from high to low occurs at input FTC3. Next is alarm mode. We can select T object or T ambient. T ambient is the ambient temperature of the sensing head, or T object, which is the temperature of the object we are measuring. Next is set point, which defines a temperature threshold for the alarm. Right now it is set to 932 degrees F. If you want to change, press enter and use the up or down arrows. Next is low limit, which is the low end of temperature measurement. This is read only. So for the sensor we have connected, the low limit is negative 40 degrees F. And if we go to the high limit, we can see that the high end temperature measurement is 1,112 degrees F, and this is read only as well. Next is factory default. If we press enter and select yes, we can restore all the settings back to original. In this case, we will select no. Next is type, and this will show us the part number of the sensing head we have connected. In this case, we are using the MI3 10LTS sensing head. Next is SN, which will give us the serial number of the sensing head we have connected. Now, if we press the down button again, it will take us to T ambient, which is the beginning of the head setup. That concludes the head setup menu. Now that we have gone through the head setup, let's go through the box setup. Again, we're going to have an outline of the box setup menu pop up on the left side of the screen for your reference. So the first part is relay mode, which is the switching behavior for the box internal alarm relay. We can press enter, and first we have normally open, which is open contact and non-alarm status. Next is permanently closed, which is permanently open contacts. Press the down button again, and we get permanently open, which is permanently closed contacts. And then if we do that again, we get to normally closed, which is closed contact in non-alarm status. We're going to put it back to normally open and select it by pressing the enter button. Next is output one mode. Here we can select what communications box will output to your temperature controller. We can select between 0 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, type J thermocouple, type K thermocouple, type R thermocouple, and type S thermocouple. Or we can disable it and it will output to high resistance. So press the down button again and go back to 0 to 5 volts and press enter. Next is the out one source, and this assigns a selected head to analog output. In this case, sensing head number one. Press the down button again and you have output one value, which defines the basis for the output value. We can select T object, which outputs the object temperature, or T ambient, which outputs the sensing head ambient temperature. Let's go back to T object and press enter. Press the down button again. Next is the out one low limit. It defines the temperature for the low end of the analog output range. This is the scaling. This is very important when you are outputting to a temperature controller. Press the down button again. This is the out one high limit, which defines a temperature for the high end of the analog output range. Press the down button again. This takes us to output two mode. We can select between 0 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, 0 to 20 milliamps, which is not available in output one mode, 4 to 20 milliamps. This is also not available in output one mode, or we can disable it and it will output to high resistance. So press the down button again and go back to 0 to 5 volts and press enter. Next is out to source, and we are selecting sensing head number one. Next is output two value, and we will set the same as output one value. We can choose between T object, which will output the object temperature, or T ambient, which will output the head ambient temperature. In this case, we'll do T object. Next is out to low limit. This is very important for scaling, so choose your low limit temperature. Press the down button, and we have out to high limit. Press the down button again. Next is factory default. If we press enter and select yes, we can restore all the settings back to original. In this case, we will select no. Press the down button. Next is temperature units. You can select between Fahrenheit or Celsius. We will leave it at Fahrenheit. Press enter. Press the down button again. Next is the key enter lock. If you press enter and select yes, you will see at the upper right hand corner there's a little lock icon. This feature allows you to save all your settings from accidentally being changed. Now you can unlock it by connecting your sensor to a computer and opening up Raytex DataTemp software, or you can unlock it by holding the page button and the enter button simultaneously for about 3 seconds, and this will unlock the sensor. So we're going to go back to key interlock. Went over that. Next is display backlight. You can leave it on, or you can select it to switch the backlight off after 60 seconds, or you can just set it to off. We will keep it on. Next, press the page button one more time. It will give you the serial number of the box, the firmware version or the rev, and the current ambient temperature of the box. This concludes our demonstration of how to set up the Raytech MI3 series sensing head. Be sure to visit solutionsdirectonline.com to purchase a Raytech MI3 series infrared sensor and browse our large selection of industrial products.